this good volume? Let's see. Hold on. Hello? A bit more. How about now? I think that's good. Hello. Hello, hello. Welcome. Let me adjust myself. Hello. I'm Saros. I've rearranged my screen, so I'm confused. Hello, Saros. Welcome to my stream. Today, like it says in the title, I'm just going to be, like, doing the crafts and things that I have half-finished, trying to get things done. I have a list on my phone. Hold on, let me actually pull that list out of what all of the things I need to do are. So I've done that and that. Do that one and then that and that. Okay, so the plan is I'm not gonna get through most of this, if any of this that I actually want to finish, but ideally I have my cross stitch that I've been working on for the past like 2-3 months. It was a Halloween cross stitch. I hope to get it done. I'm almost done. I'm so close. I want to do that, and if I get that done, I'm gonna frame it. I have a frame. I'm gonna see if I can frame it. Then probably I have a whole bunch of little wire mushrooms, little rock mushrooms that I was wire wrapping, and I finished the ones for like my friends and family and stuff, but I have a few extras I was wire wrapping for like future presents, easy things to like give away to people if I'm like a friend but I don't realize it's their birthday or something. I could just give them a rock, you know, nice and easy. But or I was also thinking if I ever get like a little like market table and sell things, or like on Etsy or something, I can like sell them as like necklaces. But I will wire wrap some of those if I have time, and if I sew or if I feel like it, I'll also work on the crochet dino nuggets that I didn't finish my friend doll for her birthday, so I need to finish it before the next time I see her. I don't know when I'm seeing Riley again, but I'll finish the dino nuggets. I didn't make anything for Miriam for Christmas. She could get a rock. She'll get a necklace. I realized I didn't make anything for Miriam. Oh no. I'll bring one and be like, do what? I feel bad, because anyway, I'm seeing her tomorrow, but. Oh, I also, if I get extra bored, my family got a whole bunch of like these super cheap for Christmas, these super cheap, like junky little Pokemon that like are not correct. Why is Chansey red? Anyway, I was gonna maybe pick some of these and make them into earrings if I feel like it. That's like a whenever I'm bored sort of thing. But that's the plan. I feel like my lighting's off in here and I don't know how to fix it. I need a light here, but like I also need this light here. Otherwise it's like worse, you know? Like, hold on. That's worse. This is at least something. My lighting's not great. I'll figure it out eventually. I don't have money for it. And look, my hair's also not dripping wet. Because I need to wash it today, but I figured I'd stream first, and then I'd wash my hair. There's my stream. There we go. I have my desktop set up when I'm streaming is, like, a lot. I've got, like, Streamlabs over here. I've got my Twitch, like, stream manager there, and then I've got my cross-stitch pattern there. But I realized my stream manager on Twitch wasn't loaded properly, so I had to refresh it. But there we go. It should be good now. Oh, I don't remember when I was working on my cross stitch. It's almost done. I'm very proud of it. Don't mind the ring and the stuff, but look at it. Oh, it's Miriam texting. I got to answer a text. Hold on. Please hold. Okay, I'm almost done my cross stitch. I've just got a little bit more. I'm trying to remember to mute my mic when I cough. I was just eating hickory sticks. It's not a sickness or anything. I've just got hickory sticks stuck in my throat. I feel like that's a Canadian thing. I'm saying that, and in my head, I know exactly what I'm talking about. But I feel like hickory sticks are Canadian. Hold on, it's gonna crinkle. Hickory sticks. I feel like this is Canadian. I could be wrong. Let me know. But I feel like it's Canadian. Okay. So. Did I fix those spots? No. So I have a few colors left, and then there's also a few spots that I realized while I was doing other things that I completely forgot. So like there's some like black stitches that I missed. I think some dark brown. But we were going to do red first. I don't need my needle minder. I love these little needle minders. This is, I don't know if anyone knows what a needle minder is, but it's this little, like, enamel pin with, like, a magnet, and you put it, like, on your embroidery or your cross stitch or whatever, and it magnets your needle to it so you don't lose it. I got two of them from this local lady. She sells at my work, and also I got them, these ones, at a market from her directly, but I just magnet them. I've got, here, let me actually show you both of the ones I have, because they're cute. If I could take them off, I've got this little mushroom, and then this little, they call it like a green witch. It's a little like crystal ball looking thing with like plants. They're super cute. When I'm not using them, I magnet them to my little metal cart that's beside me, so that way I don't lose them. I could probably also put my needle on that, huh? Yeah, I don't trust that, but I could. I don't have a lot of cross stitch left, and I want to try and get this done because I've been working on it for so long. And like, my work has been giving me more tasks to do, so I haven't had time to do my little crafts. I don't actually need this much thread. I don't like that much. Why I need a needle minder. I put my needle down and I lost it. We'll put it there. Oh, also, my sister... Which earring can you see better? My sister made these cute little earrings. And I made these cute little earrings and I think they're very cute and I like them. That's what I'm doing. Sometimes my brain doesn't work anymore. But, okay. My brain's kind of slow today. I had Christmas. I had Christmas dinner with my family, and we played board games, and then I went out shopping all Boxing Day. And that was exhausting. I get overwhelmed very easily in crowds, so it was not super fun for me when we went to the mall. Because, like, all of the stores we went to were, like, empty, like, nothing was happening. The West Edmonton Mall? Yikes. That was not fun for my little brain. I was so stressed constantly. It was crowded. Everything was happening. It was loud. I did not have fun. So... And then we went home and played board games with our family some more. me and my sisters, because I went with my sisters. But it was fun. But I'm overwhelmed. And oh, actually, let me show you my keyboard. I got this for a new keyboard for Christmas, and I absolutely love it. Look at how cute. There we go. I don't want to hit any buttons, but look at how cute it is. It's a Logitech Pop keyboard. It's Bluetooth. It's got cute buttons. It makes good noise. It sits right behind my microphone. You'll probably be able to hear this, but like, it feels like a typewriter, and I love it. I've been practicing my typing on it. When I got it, I set it up and then went onto like a typing test website so I could test how my like typing speed, and I'm a little slower than normal, but that's because the keys are different than what I'm used to. So I was a little lost, but it's so cute. I've learned to enjoy typing things for school, because you have to write so many like essays and stuff. I've gotten to the point where I actually enjoy typing things as long as I don't have to think too much. And so I wanted a keyboard that would let me enjoy typing. And because of that, I got this, and I've got so much fun typing in the winter when classes are back on. Except for I don't want to really go to all of my classes because some of them sound boring, but I have to, but it's fine. I'm so excited. I could connect it to like my laptop or like my tablet, and I could bring my keyboard to type on that. I won't. I don't have a tablet, and my laptop has a keyboard, so you know, I don't really need to bring another keyboard. It would take up way too much space, but the idea's there, so that's fun. But like, I'd wanted something that maybe lit up so I could type in the dark, but because this is so light, it's like white and like yellows and pastels, it's very light, so I can see it even when there's not a lot of lights on, which is good because I end up doing lots of homework in the middle of the night after I turn off my lights, because I can't have my lights in my room on all day or all night because my little frog's back there. One of them's up. You see him right there. Anyway, their light turns off after I feed them around 10:30. And I don't like having my lights on in my room on after that because it feels rude, because it's they're waking up. I don't want to disturb their when they're supposed to be dark. Let me tilt my camera down. Yeah, you can have the top of my head and my hands, so you can actually sort of see what I'm doing. But yeah, so like, I wanted something that lights up, but it's so bright that I can see it anyway. I'm very excited. Lots of cute things. My friends and family got me so many like bath things, like bath bombs and like face masks. So much self-care stuff. They really said, you need more self-care. And I said, thanks, bestie. I'll take it. But I have so many. I don't take that many baths because I don't like taking a bath when you don't put anything in it, you know? But I forgot I had like a bath bomb and some bubble bath, so I got them for like my birthday, which is in June, and I forgot I had them, so I haven't used them, but I've like 5 bath bombs and like 2 different bath powders and also a bubble bath. So now I can't even just do like once a month before it gets to my birthday, and I'm gonna have more bath things because that's what my friends get me for my birthday. So I'm gonna have to have a bath at least twice a month. It's not saying I don't shower. I shower. But like, bath, you know? But it's pretty fun. They also got me like lots of candy and like cute rocks. Let me show you the cute rocks my parents got me. They're frogs. They're little frogs. And they're made out of like Dalmatian jasper or something. I don't know. I don't know my rocks too well. But they're little rock frogs, one for each of my sons. They go right under my desk. I cleaned off my desk, so they go right under my desktop screen. And I cleaned off my desk so they can sit there. I also got
My friend Emily got me this snow globe. It's like a little dragon, and the snows are like little iridescent bits. It's very cute. It also goes under my desktop screen. Good. I had a pretty good Christmas. I don't have any plans for New Year's. Sometimes my family will like hang out with our like family friends, but this year my mom and dad are going to visit my aunt and cousin and second cousins, my cousin's kids, in Calgary. So we won't have our family over, so I think I'm going over to my sister's. And like staying the night, but should be fun. Sorry, I hit the microphone. Oh. I've also recently bought the ebook versions of Heaven Official's Blessing. I don't know if y'all know too much about like Chinese novels, BL novels essentially. The more popular one a few years ago, I think it was before COVID, I want to say, was like Grandmasters of Demonic Cultivation, I think is the English title. I'm gonna say the Chinese title, and I'm gonna pronounce it wrong, and I apologize, but it's Modao Zuhi, I think. Anyway, I read the novel for that. Very good. I enjoyed it. I read it when it was just like fan translated. Very good. Enjoyed it. Recommend it, and then I've read, like, most of, like, the manhwa, the cartoon-drawn version, you know? I don't know the terminology, I'm sorry. I've read most of that, I believe. At least when I read it, and then I tried watching the drama for, that's called The Untamed, I believe, and it's too different from, like, the novel. It strays too much from the novel that I can never get super into it, but I do enjoy it. But the author for the novel also wrote one, has, like, three popular ones? I don't know too much about them, but they have at least three popular ones. I don't know if that's all they have or just whatever, but, I think Heaven Official's Blessing was their first one, and then Modao, and then the Scum Villain one. I don't know that one too well, but I believe Heaven Official's Blessing is their first one, and it's so good. It's much longer, but I bought the novels online so I could read them, like, on my phone, and that's all I've been doing. I got them, like, I think Christmas Eve, and I just started the third book, and they're, like, about 400 pages each, at least, like, on my phone, 400 pages, but, like, it's very good. I enjoy it greatly. I'm having a good time reading it. I just started the book three. There's going to be six books of the English translation published. I say this because the online, it's like confusing. There's a difference between, like, I think there's like five books that the author wrote, sort of. It was in like five sort of arcs, And then, like, the ebook that I'm reading is, like, the official one, because I know, like, you can't get it free online, fan translated anywhere, because the fans want to support the author too much, and I'm like, I get it, but I don't want to pay money, but I don't regret it, because it's a good book. But anyway, yeah, there's, like, the book's calling them, like, five different arcs, even though it's, like, five different, like, novel sort of things, but it's confusing. But anyway, I just started book three out of the six. The sixth one is not out yet. It comes out in May, and I'm going to finish these, and I'm going to be very upset until May comes around, and then I'm going to probably reread all of them, because I wanted to reread, the Marazishi. I just don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, and I apologize, but I wanted to reread that, but I kept forgetting about it, and then I went and looked, and the people that I read it from that had the English fan translation only have the first, like, 20 chapters because they want to support, like, the actual, official translation and publication, and I'm like, I get it, but I just want to read the fan book. Like, I just want to read it for free. I don't want to pay money, because I think there's, like, 4 or 5, so I'm gonna wait until I get more paychecks, and then I'll probably, once I finish reading Have an Official's Blessing, I'll probably reread the Grandmasters of Demonic Cultivation, because it's just so good. I can't. It's just so good. It's very, very good. Very cozy, you know? And I want to reread it. I've been reading fanfics, but, like, that's not good enough. There's a cat scratching. But yeah, they're good. I might even cave and also read Scumvillain. I don't know if Scumvillain's translated anywhere, but I might cave and read that as well, because I like the author and they're good books. And I don't have to pretend I'm not reading anything when my parents walk by, because, like, I read fanfiction, and, like, I don't read smut because I'm asexual and I think it's gross. Like, you do you, bestie. I don't want to read that. But I don't want my parents to question me on why I'm reading fanfiction. So I don't, like, I'll hide my phone. Or, like, I'll change what I'm doing on my phone if they walk by. But when I'm reading this, I don't have to hide, because I told them I'm reading a book. And it's an actual book. And I'm not reading, like, fanfiction. Like, it's a book. So, like, they can't say anything. They can judge me, but, like, I'm actually reading a book. So, like, you know? But it's very good, and I just, I love it. It's so good. I just enjoy it. And also, any books that can make me cry are good books. I cry a lot, but, like, not always over books. There are some fanfictions I've read that are so good, they make me just, like, sob. But it's, like, really hard to pretend you're not reading fanfiction when you're also laying in bed crying over it. It's a rough time. Some of these fanfiction authors are, like, top-notch. Like, write your own books. The thing with fanfiction, I think fanfiction is a great creative medium because it allows people to create stories without having to work too much about creating the character themselves, you know? Because the character is already created. So if you're reading the fanfiction, you're going into it knowing the character, so the author can just skip the characterization of the, like, the creating the character and its backstory and all that, and go straight into, like, plot, which makes it much more fun to read, because then you don't have to worry too much about characterization as much. You still do. The best fan fiction still has a good amount of characterization. If that makes sense. I'm not like a literature English person. It's just whatever. But, like, yeah, the fan fictions still need to, like, you need to be able to do that. But it's, you start off, you have, like, a better base to start off on than traditional, like, writing any sort of novel from a fresh start. Which makes it fun. And it also, I'm the type of person that, I'll consume a piece of, like, media, like a show on Netflix or whatever, and then I'll be like, that was so good, I don't want to leave, like, the realm of feeling it gave me, you know? Because, like, it made me feel nice, it made me feel good and, like, cozy, and I don't want to stop that, so then I'll read fanfiction to hold on to that cozy feeling. That's what I like it for. And again, I don't read smut. I think smut's gross. From my personal standpoint, I don't want to read smut. I'm just reading nice, like, cozy, good relationships. Like, friendships. There's usually some sort of relationship because I'm a hopeless romantic at heart. But, you know. It's good. I'm also the type of person that when I read so much fanfiction. Like, so much. Too much. I have my AO3 account is for, like, the email I use is, like, only for that, really. So whenever I get, like, emails saying a story's updated, I'm normally not always in the mood to read that story anymore, you know? Like, it's a good story and I want to continue, but I'm not always in the mood to read it, or, like, I don't have time. But because I do that in so many different fandoms, I have, like, tags in my Gmail account. So I'll be like, oh, this is for this fandom, put it there. One of my goals for the new year is to get through some of that fanfiction. Because lots of the ones haven't been updated in, like, 3 years. And it's like, I need to, like, unsubscribe and just, like, clean it up. But I just haven't got around to it because I just, like... I'm not in the mood for Yuri on Ice fanfiction right now. Like, I just want to read about something else. But that's one of my goals. But I started reading Heaven Official's Blessing, and now you know I'm gonna finish that. And then I'm gonna... What? And then I'm gonna... If I can find, I don't know, the sixth book or whatever, or I'm just gonna spoil it for myself and just read fanfiction anyway. Because I'm going to finish it and I'll be like, that was so good, I need more. But it's, you know. And then I'm not going to actually get through any of the ones. But that's my plan for the next year, is to clean up my email. My fanfiction email. Because it's a lot. I've got a problem. I just enjoy books and I stopped wanting to read, like, novels, like, teen fantasy novels, because, like, they're good, but, like, I don't know, they all have very similar tropes sometimes. And so, like, I stopped reading, like, physical books, and I'm just reading, like, online. I also want to actually read Percy Jackson. I've never actually read it. I bought the books online, because I wanted to read them on my phone, because I read better. Like, I like reading on the bus and stuff, but bringing a book is, like, troublesome. And, like, it's not fun, and, like, it's easier to just pull out your phone and read and stop whatever you're reading than pulling out a physical book. So, but yeah, I've got so much reading I want to do, and, like, my sisters and my dad got me books for me. Show you the books I got for Christmas. So I've got this one on Scientology. I've got this one on the end of traditional religion, pagans and the rise of Christianity. And then I've got one called Beneath the Moon, and it's like fairy tales from all over the world, but look at how pretty the art is. There's like art on, it's like art and a story. And, like, the story on each page. And it's so cute. So I've got lots of books to read. I've got a lot of reading to do. So. That's exciting. But. That's my New Year plan, I think. I mean, also lots of sewing and crafts. I heard doors. I think my parents might be home. Nope, incorrect. Must be a different house. if my parents were home, I was gonna text them that I'm streaming. I didn't actually let them know I was streaming, and I don't want them to disturb. But yeah, I know I've got lots of things I need to do in the new year. So tiring. I always end up talking about my future plans on streams. I don't know why. That's just what ends up happening. Anyway, I've gotten 3 mushrooms done. You can see the red. I'm working on the red ones. This guy's looking very cute. My hair was itching my chin. I wanted to start working on cosplays for next year in this month. But I haven't got around to it yet. And we don't have all the fabric for the one I was gonna start. So I don't think I'm gonna start it yet. I think I'm going to work on our Full Metal Alchemist cosplays. Or FMA. Because that's what we need first. And also, I think it'll be easier than my Link one I was gonna do. Just because it's like, it's pants and a jacket and like a butt cape. And I was gonna work, I was gonna do costume at a time. But I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make my pants and butt cape and then make my sisters. Because me and Sarah are being Risa and Olivier from FMA. So the same outfits. Essentially, so I kind of wanted to, I think it's easier if I just like make one and then make the other directly after, but going off that, I also think it's easier if I work on like my pants and butt cape and then do her pants and butt cape, so that way that's good, and then work on my jacket and then work on her jacket, so that way that's good as well, rather than doing my pants, butt cape, and jacket, and then her pants, butt cape, and jacket, because then I'll like, remember what I'm doing better, you know? If I had just made a pair of pants, I can make another pair of pants easier than I can make a jacket. That makes sense. It's easier to do something repetitively. So I think I was gonna make our pants first. Our pants, jacket, and butt cape all need to be done ideally end of February. The pants are similar to the pants I made for like my big cargo pants and whatever. I think they're similar to that. I was gonna have to ask my sister about that. But if they are similar, then I already essentially have the pattern and know how to make it. And I made those pants in like 3 days. Like the base pants part, like 2-3 days. So I should be able to, and these are just like blue twill, nothing super fancy, no pocket, like no sewn on pockets or anything. I was maybe gonna do some research on military outfits, like uniforms, like fancy military uniforms, not like camo and stuff, but like, you know, the solid like military-esque, like not the camo or anything, like browns, like our American military, like the good, like I want to say like European military sort of stuff. I was gonna do research on that and like look at the seams on those just so I can get as much accuracy as possible. And I also wanted to rewatch FMA. I'll have to get to that, but just because they aren't they essentially like military-esque? So I want their outfits to represent that in a way, because they're not like super complicated outfits by themselves. I was thinking about it just now, and there's a decent amount of like binding and stuff. Now, I'm bad at what's called stitching in the ditch. If you don't sew, you might not know what stitching in the ditch is, but it's like when you sew down a seam and it hides your stitching. I'm not good at that. So, and like the back side of it always looks bad. What would be easier is if I just hand stitched it all. But the thing is, that would take a lot of work. But I think it would look nicer, and I really want these costumes to be like top quality. Because again, they're not going to be super intricate in themselves. So I want them to be like quality made. And I think that would be nicer hand stitching it. Because then you don't get all the stitching lines as well. Because as much as you're like, oh, it's a, you're making a costume out of an anime, there's not much stitching lines in anime, it's whatever. It's still nicer to try and make it look as accurate as possible in whatever ways you can. So, I think I'll just, at least on the edge of this skirt, I think I'm gonna pull up a picture once I finish this mushroom real quick. I'm just gonna pull up a picture of their uniform and see. Also, if I did research on military stuff, that would be good to add to the panel me and Miriam are doing. FMA. I'll just do visa. Nope, not that. Yeah, so there's like. Yes, there's not much, like, four stitching lines. They've got, don't mind me, they've got, like, the fly stitching and, like, I think back of the butt cape. But it's all, the cape and the jacket are all, like, hemmed with bias, with, like, silver bias tape or, like, gray bias tape, essentially. And I don't want to do that with machine because it'll look messy. I think I'll have to do that with by hand. It will look so much better if I do it by hand, because then I can get like the corners nice and good. But then there's some on like the princess seams and like the pockets. I probably also by hand. The princess seams are the ones that I think I don't really want to stitch on top of. I might do those by hand as well. I'm gonna be lining the jacket and stuff, so that shouldn't be too much of an issue. But like, yeah, it's gonna be a lot of hand sewing, but I can do it on stream. That's what you're here for. To watch me do the work that I need to do elsewhere. But yeah, I think I'm gonna hand stitch it. It'll just look so much nicer. Because I'm, again, they're not like super intricate costumes, like piece-wise. It's not like overwhelming, like wow factor, like you're so distracted by like everything going on, you don't look at the quality. Because they're so simple, you look at the quality more. At least for like judges, I would assume. So I don't want to skimp on the quality. Even if this isn't, like, our main costume of the year, I don't want to skimp on quality. The dilemmas of a perfectionist. Yeah, I'll probably hand sew it. Just because there's not a lot to make. They're fairly simple in general. The jacket is what I'm more worried about because it's, like, jackets are funky. I'm gonna have to find a pattern to base it off of so I can alter that and go from there, because if I can find a pattern, I don't want to draft a whole jacket pattern myself, because that'll turn out shit. But, oh, because I'm doing it myself, I can make sure it's, the collars are nice and tall, like I want them to be. Yes. Oftentimes, never said it to my mom, because she used to be the one that makes our costumes, but oftentimes, like, things in animes, you know how in animes their collars will be like this tall and stuff. Oftentimes for us, our collars are not that tall or don't stand up that much, And like, it's fine, it's whatever, but I want mine too. I want to be peak anime. And now, because I'm making the costume myself, I can do that. Nice. Very exciting. But I'm probably gonna work on the pants first, and then the butt cape, and then the jacket for both me and Sarah's, and then work on Carrie's like jumpsuit overall suit thing for Winry, because that should take me like 2 weeks. It doesn't have to be fitted. It doesn't have to be fancy. It's just like some overalls. I could probably theoretically, depending on how much schoolwork I end up having and how much like homework I need to do, I could theoretically be able to get all three costumes done in like 2 months. They will definitely be done end of March, and I don't need them till mid-May. I also need to style my wig and I'm probably not going to make, because I'm doing Riza with her jacket off, so she's got like a black mock neck t-shirt thing, and then like gun holsters. They're like dual arm cross back gun holster things, but I can't have guns at conventions, so I was going to make a dog. But anyway, the gun holsters, I kind of want to make, just like try and make, but I also feel like that's not going to turn out nice. So I don't really, like, I want it to be good, you know? And there's these kind of expensive, they're like dual camera holsters. That's like almost the exact shape I need. But it doesn't have like a pocket thing to put like a gun. If it's got clips instead, but we'll see. That's my backup plan, is to buy one of those, because then I know for sure that I'll have one. But I think I'd found patterns on Etsy that would work to make the gun holsters, but I want to make those, and then I want to make a little husky plushie, probably like hand-sewn felt or something, so I could put him in my gun holster. So that way I get a prop that's not just a jacket, and also Riza gets her dog. But I can probably do that. I can do that in like a week or two. That's like a April thing. And then I'll want to try and get as much of Link done before Otafest as possible as well. Because, Breath of the Wild 2, Tears of a Kingdom comes out beginning of May, and we want our costumes for mid-July. So, we've got to hustle. We can do it for sure. I'm only gonna be working. Like, I don't have classes or anything, so it shouldn't be too much of an issue, but it depends on how complicated the costumes are. But we have no idea what Carrie and Sarah are doing. I just wanna cosplay. That's what I wanna do right now. Yeah, I'm meeting my friend Miriam tomorrow, because we want to have a panel at Otafest about like how to plan your cosplay. Not even like how to pick a cosplay, how to make a cosplay, how to plan to make your cosplay, because a lot of work goes into it. As you can tell by me talking, I'm not even like, haven't started much, and I'm already just like, got lots of things in this brain. Like picking your costume, dissecting each individual piece of the costume bit by bit, so you know exactly what pieces you have to make, and then like what pieces you need, and then from there figuring out what you have to buy or what you have to make, and like or what you have to alter, and then from that, if you're buying something, that's like, is it you're buying it from like a cosplay shop, or you like thrifting it or something, or like from, and like if you're gonna make something, how are you gonna make it? Is it a clothing piece? Do you have a pattern? Like, how do you, what if you have a pattern that's close, how do you alter, like do you need to alter a pattern? What skills will you need to learn to make this? Like things, even just like finding reference photos, things like that. Me and Miriam are gonna meet up and try and write that all out and then apply for a panel. Cause I think it would be fun to have a nice little like how to step 0.5 on making your cosplay. Not even like the first step of making your cosplay, the prep before making your cosplay. Done with the red now. As you can tell, I can cross stitch while I'm talking faster than I can do anything else while I'm talking. If you've been on any of my other streams, you'll know that often when I'm talking, I get distracted and don't do as much work. And I only did that a little bit with this cross stitch. It's because I cross stitch at my work a lot, so I'll like be chatting or I'll be like walking around and like helping customers and like stuff to cross stitch. There's 3 main mushrooms. And then the 2 on the side. Yes, Red is done. I can see him. He's almost done. Just a few like gray bits and then fixing up, like there's like the white up here. And these mushrooms here don't have stems. I forgot about the stems of those mushrooms. But I'm almost done. And then I might just end stream. Once I finish. If I get this actually finished and framed, that's probably enough for one stream. Because I have so many things I need to make and do that I don't know if I really want to sit here too much more. Love y'all, but also I'm tired. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do the gray and then I'll fix up the pieces I missed. I actually kind of want to fix up the pieces I missed so I can like finish a color and be done, you know? It is black that I'm missing here, correct? It's just like 4 stitches of black. I don't need this much thread. I just need like 4 stitches. I've also been last night. I keep missing Charlie Slimesicle streams that I want to watch because I'm always like busy, or I'm like, oh, I don't really want to watch a stream right now. I'm not like in a position to watch a stream at this moment, and that means I'm missing the streams that I actually want to watch, and I'm kind of upset with myself because Charlie Slimesicle played The Devil in Me I think like 9 days ago, and I didn't know about it until like last night when I saw the VOD on YouTube, and I was like, oh, that's what that was. This is way too much fun. I don't need this much fun. But I saw the VOD last night and I was like, oh, I want to watch that. And it's like 6 hours long. So I I was watching that, and I have all last stream I talked about all of like the I think it was last stream the cross stitch patterns I'm making for like my friends and sisters for their birthdays. And I was looking at it, and my god, is there a lot of different colors for some of these cross stitches, and they look almost the same color even in the pattern. And like, from when I've organized cross, like, DMC brand thread, some of these threads look the same color. And so, like, I don't really want to buy, like, 30 different color threads per cross stitch. That doesn't seem like an effective use of my time. So I'm taking the pattern, going into the cross stitch making pattern, software I have, and, currently, I'm taking the pattern and transferring it directly over there, stitch by stitch. And then I'm going to zoom out, and then anything that's like the same color, just make it all one color. Rather than like two, because there's some of them where it's like, these two colors, I'm putting them down, they look the exact same. Like, you cannot tell me these are different colors. And so I'm gonna go and like make those the same. And then also, I don't think it's quite an actual circle, which upsets me. I'm pretty sure it's off and like not a full complete circle. So I was gonna fix that and make it an actual nice circle rather than like a slightly squash. I think it's like, I wanna say it's like 88 stitches across, but like only 84 stitches tall. It's like 4 stitches off, and that's like, what, like a centimeter off? But like, that's enough. It's like half a centimeter top and bottom, but that's enough to notice, and it bothers me. So I bought these patterns, and then I'm gonna fix them all up to make them better, and then I was gonna do it like one at a time sort of thing, or like whenever I had free time, whenever I'm like, don't have anything to do with my hands while I'm sitting at my computer wanting to watch YouTube. I still want to do that Minecraft one, the Minecraft painting, but I got tired of it because I couldn't get the skull to look nice. I tried like, cause I was going in like, my like paint software and trying to simplify the colors on that before I put them on the cross stitch thing, and it didn't work. So I think what I'm gonna do is straight up, like individual color pick them and put them on the cross stitch pattern, and then lots of them are going to be the same, and like go from there, because there's not like a billion different colors you can choose from. There's only like 300 or something like that. And then like simplify from that a bunch. And like keep simplifying everything so it like is also not like 70 different colors. Cause it's got to be a lot to get the effect, but I don't want it to be that much, you know? I accidentally cross-stitched a hair in here. I don't know if I missed a complete, like, row when I was doing this. It's fine. I just skipped it. It's not like I accidentally, like, squished down. Which I did a bit. The hand on this guy, his name's Leshy, is what this pattern is called. I messed up a bit with some of the stitches, but I didn't, like, I did it, like, twice, and I did two different ways, and I didn't want to fix it, and it looks fine. Looks good enough. So, I just left it, because I didn't want to fix it, and, like, nobody's gonna notice. It's one of his little thingies. No one's gonna notice. Especially because no one's gonna be comparing my work. And I didn't take pictures of the bags I made my friends. I completely forgot. But They turned out very cute, and I'm very proud of them. I don't remember when the last time I talked to y'all was. I think it was before that. But yeah, I'm very proud of them. They turned out very cute. Oops, sorry. There's that done. Now this closes in the stem. But yeah, I'm gonna go through and see what photos I've taken of things in the next couple days. Let me actually write that down because I keep forgetting to do that. Dig. Okay. Post things I've made. What have I made recently? I have felt duck, felt calcifer, this cross stitch when I finish it, the quilted bag, oh, the pencil case I never took a photo of. My table runner I made. Got lots of things I need to post. Some of these I might put into like all at once sort of thing. Like, oh, look at these things I made. But I've got lots of things that I just haven't posted pictures of because I forgot. So I'll try and do that. So you can see all the things I've made. Or I might see how many pictures I have and then just put it all in one post being like, some other things I've, like, these are some things I made in the last month, and then have another post, end of the year post of like, or like a reel. Yeah, an end of the year reel of like things I've made throughout the year I think will be cute. Talk about this board game I played with my family yesterday. I don't know if we've ever played it before, but it was very fun. I'm going to make my friends play with me next time we hang out and they want to play board games because I enjoyed it. I don't remember what color. Don't hold your needle in your mouth like I do. I have experience. As you can tell, I can also talk around it pretty good. At least I think I'm talking around it pretty good. Just don't be like me, because this is dangerous. 3375, right? Yeah, 3375. That's 3371. 71. I can't read numbers. 3371. That's just one. But, hold on, let me get this thread, and then I'll talk to you about this game. It's called Mountain of Madness. It was very fun. Hold on. I'll also do it like this. So it was like, we're expeditioners trying to figure out why this mountain is making people mad, while also trying to not go mad ourselves. And it's very fun. And because there was like five of us, the way it was played was, we all start, it's like a little mountain thing, and you like work your way up, and you've got four different like types of materials, and you're trying to give the proper amount of materials to pass it or whatever. And during that, we're also we started off all a little bit mad. So we had these madness cards, and there's three levels of madness cards. And we each had a madness card that we started out with that we had to, while we were discussing what cards we needed to play for the thing, we had to, do that madness card. So there was, one of the ones I had that I enjoyed, I think it was a level 2 madness, but it was, the first one I had was easy, I'll just say that one first. It was just, I was forgetful, so I could only hold one card in my hand, where everyone else had three. I could only hold one. So, that wasn't too bad, but then, if you fail, you might possibly go more mad, or, etc. If you win, you could also end up getting more mad, because you get a ruin, but it makes you more mad. Things like that. It was very fun, very funny to do. One of the ones, I think it was a level 2 madness I had, was that I had to keep my distance. I had to stand at least 10 feet away from the game table when we were discussing. But it's also funny, we didn't play it super roleplay. There's also supposed to be a timer, but it was a 30-second timer, and that's not nearly enough time for 5 people to discuss what they need to do. House rules, nixed the timer, said no timer, good. But, you're also supposed to play, once you put cards down, you're not supposed to talk at all, and you're just supposed to wait until the timer runs out. We just put our cards down and then did a thumbs up. My mom kept talking sometimes, though. And then once you, flip over the cards and start checking that you all played the right amount of cards and whatever, you're supposed to pretend that nothing ever happened. That, your madness was, you act completely normal afterwards, as if nothing had happened, nothing was going on, things like that. So I thought that was pretty funny. We didn't roleplay, that much. It would be fun to, but, it's my family. They're not great at that. It's also a little difficult when it's, one of the ones I had was, essentially, it was, nervous. You can only, point to the cards in your hand to play. You can only speak when they're shown, but you can't, when you're showing the cards, you can only do it after you've played the cards. You can't put the cards in the pile yourself, but it's, if you're the leader, you sort of have to read out what you need. So I sort of, fibbed it a bit, and I played it how I was, nervous about my hand, so I couldn't talk about it, but I could talk about other things, is how I played that. Which might not have been completely accurate, but it worked best for how we were playing. One of the funny ones, we played it, twice. The second time, we started out, me and my sister Sarah had, very similar madnesses, and it was so funny, because mine was when you flip the time over, so when you flip the tile card over and start, figuring out what you need, I have to shake everyone's hand in the group before we start, essentially. And so, that's funny enough as it is, but paired with my sister Sarah, who is, cheerleader, who had to high-five everyone in the group when we started, it just became we started, and I was shake, 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 and Sarah was high-fiving after me, and then we shook hands and then high-fived. It was so funny. It was kind of inconvenient, because then I just had the giggles after we had done that, so it was hard to tell, be I have 4 boxes, because I was just giggling, but it was good. My sister Carrie had one where she had a finger mustache, and she would only speak to you if you also had a finger mustache, which was very funny. At one point she would also only speak if she'd raise her hand, and she'd also only speak if you called on her. But it was also funny because when she had the finger mustache, the first round she had it, my sister Sarah had a madness where she couldn't look at the table. She had, turned around in her seat. I don't remember exactly what that was, but she had turned around in her seat, so she couldn't see. So I had figured out what this was, and so Sarah was, the leader and asking questions, and Carrie couldn't speak without a mustache. So Sarah would say something. We could also talk about our madnesses. Sarah would say something, and then I'd repeat it to Carrie with my finger mustache. And then we'd go from there. But then the next round, Sarah was still turned around. Sarah had no idea what was happening, but I had gotten more, a little more mad, and I could only respond with yes or no. So I, like, questions, essentially. I could only respond with yes or no, and so, like, I couldn't talk to Carrie anymore, because, like, she can't talk unless you talk to her with a finger mustache, but I can't start conversations. I can only say yes or no. So, like, it was kind of upsetting that we couldn't talk, because I figured it out so quickly. It was very funny. But yeah, I think it would be a very fun game to play with my friends. And so, now that we've played that, and I know how to play it well enough that I can teach my friends without reading the instructions, is generally, my friends all have, like, ADHD, you know? Short attention spans. They don't want to play long games. at least, like, my close friends. So, if we play a game, someone has to know how to play it first. Sorry, people are whack. Oh, now I've disturbed my layout. Nope, okay, hold on. But yeah, anyway, as I was saying, before I got distracted, my friends all have, like, ADHD and stuff. They can't pay attention to things. So unless you know how to, if we're playing a new game to them, they have to, like, someone has to know how to play it. Otherwise, nobody wants to read the instructions. Because then they'll lose interest in it. it's like hurting a group. Is what I've learned. We can't play new games. Someone has to be able to play it. Otherwise, they'll play do something else while you're reading the instructions, and then they maybe won't even want to play it anymore. So, like, oftentimes, like, because they're my sister's games, I'll usually play them a couple times with my sisters so I know how to do it, and I'll bring out the instruction book just for, like, how many cards and stuff, and, like, fact-checking. But I can usually explain what's happening to my friends well enough that they can easily understand what we're doing, and I, like, know what's happening, so I can explain it to them, and they can enjoy the game, because it's fun. I'm almost done! Cute. But yeah, like, my friends are, I'm making so much noise as I'm talking, my friends are bad at paying attention to things, so if you know how to do something, they're much more likely to be able to follow what's going on if someone knows what's happening. So, but because I've played that game with my sisters now, in my family, I know how to play Mountain of Madness, and I can make my friends play it. Because they enjoy more complicated games. It's just, they have short attention spans. Love them to death. But my friends have short attention spans. So we can't play long games very often. There's one game me and my sisters play that I think is so much fun. It's called Time Stories. I think it's a very fun game. The thing is, me and my sisters, we play it with our friend Jasmine. It's long. It's like a couple hours. It's like an event sort of thing. And like it could be more roleplay than we play it. We don't play it super roleplay. But, it's, cause it's, each like new sort of expansion pack, you can't play the game again. Like I could because it's been so long and like I don't really remember it, but like you know the outcome and stuff, and if I played it with a different group of people it would be fun, but we have so many house rules for that we could never play with anyone else who knew the game, because we cheat so much because the game's not nearly play tested enough to be effective as a board game, because there's so many ways you can lose and it's so like impossibly hard to win it first try. So like there's no way. So we cheat, but it's fine. Yeah, it's impossibly hard to play, but it's so much fun because it's like you're agents from the future going into the past to try and like fix the timelines or whatever, and it's so much fun. And I don't think my sister's ever planning on getting rid of it, but if they do, I'm gonna get them to just give it to me, and then I'll try and get my friends to play it with me. Because again, I don't remember it well enough. You can sort of replay it, but like I don't remember it well enough that I wouldn't be able to play it with my friends or like a completely different group of people. I might have like some memories, but it's definitely like long form. It's an event. You start at like noon and you're done at like 4 p.m. because it's a long game, but it's so much fun. It's not really worth the money though. Don't recommend buying it. If you can buy it like you, if you want to play it, buy it like used or any sort of like board game store, like board game shop or like cafe, something. Don't buy it new. It's not really worth it unless you have a lot of money. And like it's not playtested enough, so it's not always the most fun, but we're not like super hardcore board game people, we just do it for fun, so it's not like a big deal for us, because if you add enough house rules to it, it's fun. And you can't like play it with different people, it has to be the same people every time you play the different levels, because they like connected. Enjoy board games. I really just want to finish this. Like, I kind of, if you can tell, I'm kind of, oh, you see my sweatpants when I'm like this. I'm kind of tired, but I want to finish. And I only got a little bit left, so I want to finish this cross stitch before I move on to anything else. And by move on, I mean end stream and do something else. I don't want to take a break. Thank you for chatting, but I don't want to take a break. Because my break will just be ending stream. I'm running out of things to talk about though. My cat's a silly girl. She, whenever she lays, we have nice long cuddles laying in bed. Maybe in a bit. Me and my cat have nice long cuddles laying in bed, but whenever I sneeze, she always gets very startled. It's really funny to watch, but she's very silly big girl. But found out recently my cat is, I thought she was like 17 pounds. I didn't think she was that heavy. I carry her with one arm around the house I think it's not a big deal, you know? Took her to the vet recently. She's 19 pounds. We have a cat. Good. Cats are good. Yeah, but no, I took her to the vet recently just for like a checkup. She's 19 pounds. I did not realize my cat was 19 pounds. I carry her with one arm. I just like scoop her. I didn't think she was that heavy. But apparently, I've got a very fat cat. So we're trying to like cut down how much food she gets and stuff. But she's just so cute. It's just she's a big girl. She's a big girl, so we don't wanna give her too much food, but she's just so cute. It amazes me because sometimes I'll wake up like middle of the night or like 7 a.m. whenever I have an alarm going off, and I'll wake up to my alarm going off. But when I open my eyes, my 20-pound, like my 19-pound cat is laying on my chest. She's just right here. And somehow, I don't wake up from that. Somehow, my alarm is what wakes me up, not my 20-pound cat climbing onto my chest and laying down. I don't know what that says about me, but like, apparently I don't wake up to a cat laying on me. I just wake up to alarms. But not even really then, because I'll wake up to my alarm and then I'll turn it off and fall back asleep. I'm very bad at getting up at my alarms. So I have alarms, like 20 alarms in the morning. And even then that doesn't always work. If I go to sleep knowing I have to wake up in the morning because I'm like doing something or like I'm going to school or work or something, it's easier for me to wake up, but generally it takes me like a lot of alarms. I wouldn't necessarily say I'm a super heavy sleeper. Actually, no, I probably am a super heavy sleeper. I just don't wake up to alarms. Or my cat laying on me. I mean, it probably doesn't help that I have like 7 blankets and one of them is like a 20-pound weighted blanket. So I've already got a weighted blanket on me, and then like a 19-pound cat probably isn't that much more to my brain. I don't know. Or it's because I'll fall asleep with her on my lap sometimes, so waking up to her on my chest doesn't seem that weird to my brain. I don't know what it is, but I think it's kind of funny. I'm from Canada. Alberta, Canada. Very snowy. Currently, it is snowing. So that's fun. At least it's not minus 30 anymore. It was minus 30 Celsius. For the past, like, couple weekend or whatever. But it's now minus 9. Wow, that's balmy outside. No jacket needed. That's great weather. Ah, Dubai, fun. Hi, Luna. She meowed at me. Meow. Hi, you wanna come say hello to Twitch stream, Tuna?
No.
Come here. Yeah. Don't just flop. This is my 19-pound cat. Very good. She's a very good girl. Isn't that right? Yeah? You gonna purr? I don't know if you're loud enough. That was very cute. Thank you, Tuna. You want to sit on my lap for attention? Because that's what you want. There. Little guest. I have to sit back here now. Should still be able to hear me just fine.
now have a guest streamer, my cat Luna. I think that might be my parents though, hold on. We'll just take my headphone out. No need for a headphone. You're in the way. I'm almost done cross-stitching. I just want to finish this. I probably won't frame it. I'll just take a picture of it framed. Are you leaving? Okay, goodbye. Parents were out playing Pokemon Go all day, so it's coming back from that. Fun times. I have so many cross stitch patterns that I want to do. I got this cute like purpley Ida cloth for cross stitch, and I want to do like, I could either do like cute little clouds or like bubbles, or I also wanted to do a crow, and I feel like he'd look super cute. But I also have all my friends' presents, so I've got so many things to make. I like cross stitch though. I just picked it up in October, and I'm having a grand old time. I did mess up a bit on some of the black here, so it's a little funny, but that's fine. Christmas was good. It was fun. Just hung out with my parents and my sisters. Nice chill day. We were gonna have my great aunt. I was telling my parents I'm home, that came home, but yeah, I was just, hung out with we were gonna have my great aunt over, but she didn't feel up to it, so it was just my family. It was nice, it was good. Fun time. Christmas isn't my favorite. I don't like holidays because I like to hang out with like my family and like whatever. I'm not a super Christmas person. I prefer Halloween. Christmas has just become so capitalist that there's like, I enjoy opening presents, don't get me wrong. I also enjoy giving presents to people. But yeah, Halloween's my favorite. Christmas, I just feel like, is too capitalistic, and everyone's always trying to be like, Christmas cheer, and it's like, what Christmas cheer? You just want me to spend money at your big store. So I'm not a super Christmas person, because I feel like it's never really been, like, the best sort of meaning behind it. And, like, because there's things like Christmas and, like, birthdays, I don't feel like I feel like it would be odd for me to just give my friends presents all year round, which is like what I want. I just want to be able to like make things and give my friends things, and like it gives me an excuse to, but if there was no Christmas, I'd also just
make excuses to give my friends more things and stuff, so I'm not a super Christmas person. I enjoy the holidays, but like the whole manufactured Christmas cheer is not really what I'm in for. I'm also not religious, so it's not a super like important thing to me. I'm more agnostic than anything. Agnosis, the one where you don't believe one way or the other, really. But yeah, I don't know. Christmas is just... Yeah, I'm in university to be a teacher. I've got another year and a half left. But I'm in university. It's been fun. Just finished all my finals up before Christmas, so that's good. It's been fun. Met lots of cool people. I've had a fun time. Can't wait to finish. University's good. I'm very tired of it though. I went straight to university. I went straight to university from high school. I've had like no break, so I've been stressed. But very excited. I see, that's fun. You know, I'm in it for education, to be a teacher. So it's exciting. It's a lot of money. University is expensive. Doesn't help that I have expensive hobbies. But I'm so close to being done that I'm gonna finish my university before I do anything else, because I do want to be a teacher. I like education, but I've never really got too much chance to explore anything else, so I want to get my degree and then use it as something to like fall back on after I do some like traveling. I hope I'd be a good teacher too. Everyone tells me they're excited for me to be a teacher, but yeah, I want to teach like art and fashions, so, you know, very in my wheelhouse. But I've been told by my peers and friends that I'd make a good teacher, so I'm hoping they're not lying to me. But it's fun. I do want to like try out different things. Like I want to maybe do content more, maybe travel a bit after I graduate. Don't go straight into teaching. I want to like learn about myself a bit more, grow as a person more before I go, because otherwise I'll have gone from high school to university to teaching and like no break in between, and there's not really a whole lot of chance to figure out like who you are as a person when you're just doing school your whole life. And like, granted there is, and like, yeah, you don't wanna hate your job. And like, I'm going in for an education for art or fashion, both things that I very much enjoy, and I enjoy like helping and teaching people about, so like I don't think I'm gonna hate it. I don't know, I'd like to learn a bit more about myself as a person. But I do need money to do that. Oh wow. Wild. But yeah, so I plan to graduate and then, I don't know, move out. Learn to be my own person. That's a bad teacher. Taking bribes? Awful. Yeah. teachers should get paid more. But I mean, in the end, doing things against the policy though does essentially ruin your career. Teachers have gotten sued for things that they didn't do, and that even though they were found like not guilty, it's ruined their career. So you gotta be careful as a teacher. Gotta be careful in any job, but teachers especially. I'm excited. I don't really play too many video games. I watch people play video games, but the most I play is like Legend of Zelda stuff, but not even all that much recently. I haven't played it in a few years. I'm excited for the new Legend of Zelda game to come out, but I'm not a big video game person. Personally playing them myself. Again, I enjoy watching people play them. Friends, YouTubers, things like that, but that's fun. Trust your gut. If you make something, ask your friends or family, or just post it, see what the people say about it. I go off the belief of you want a wide variety of opinions of things, you know, scientific process and all. To get the proper data, you need a wide set group of people to comment on it. You can't get proper data with only a few people, so yeah, just post it. See what happens. See what the algorithm says. Yeah, maybe go through like Twitter or something. People always up to give opinions on Twitter, or Reddit, I'm sure. Reddit's probably a good place to go to get people's opinions. I wouldn't be, I'm a noob. I don't use any social media, really. I don't use too much social media, I wouldn't know. I'm almost done my cross stitch. I've just got like a few more. Excited for this to be done. I've been working on it since mid-October. Oopsie. Made an oops. So many people, and I'm just sitting here in silence. So sorry, y'all. It's just a chill cross-stitch stream. to make. I've got a lot of sewing I need to do as well in the next bit. But again, sewing by machine is not a stream activity. It's loud, it's inconvenient, and it doesn't fit up here in my room. So I can't, but I've got little bat pattern. So like a plush bat pattern. It's from BZ Arts, I believe. If you're looking up like bat plush pattern. It was nice meeting you too. Have a good night. Thank you. But yeah, I've got it's a bat plush pattern. It's like the main one you'll see. If you look it up, I think it's from BZ Art is the name. But it's pretty easy to make. Very cute. I made one for my friend's boyfriend's birthday. And he liked it. So I'm gonna make two more because I've got two friends from printmaking that I don't know exactly when their birthdays are, but I want to make them things. So I'm gonna make them before the new year, and then I'll just have them in my room, you know? Same as what I want to do with like all the cross stitch patterns I'm making my friends. I want to make them nice and early so that way I'm not stressed about making it like a week before. And that way I can just be like, especially for like if I make the bats for my friends from uni, I can just, if they're like, oh hey, it's my birthday, I'll be like, I have a present for you. Or like, why did you tell me ahead of time? I have your present. Because I haven't made them things as presents, and I feel bad. But I know one of them, his birthday is in January. I just don't know what day in January. That's why I need to get them done quickly. And the other one, I don't know when their birthday is. I have no I know the year they're born, but I don't know when their birthday is. It's bad. I don't know. It feels weird to ask when their birthday is. I mean, if I see him again, I might straight up, like, see him in January. I might straight up just be like, hey, when are y'all's birthdays? Because I want to give them presents, but if I don't know when their birthday is, how can I give them presents? My love language is giving gifts. I constantly am just like, let me give you a thing, please. I've given people things, and they're like, you didn't have to get me anything, and I'm like, no. You don't understand, I did have to get you something. And then they look at me like I'm crazy. It's just, I'm just a gift-giving person. I think I've also only got like 4 more stitches left. 3 more. Literally 3 stitches. Very exciting. Okay. But you know, I'm the type of person that gives gifts to everyone. But on the contrast to that, any date I've ever been on, I don't give gifts to people. Because it's like, it's the first date, I don't know you, but they've given gifts to me and it makes me feel bad. Because like the first date I ever went on, she made me cookies and like, gave me flowers from her garden, and I was like, this is so sweet, I didn't get you anything because this is the first time I've ever meeting you in person. And I feel like, felt like that was weird. I need to just have, like, a bucket of gifts. And so that way if I'm meeting someone or, like, anything, I can just always, like, have a few in my purse or whatever. And so if I don't feel bad, that's what I'm gonna do with the rocks, honestly. I might keep, like, 1 or 2 in my purse. So that way if anyone ever just, like, gives me a gift and I don't have a return gift, I could just be like, rock. Just because I always feel bad. I always feel bad when someone gives me something. Because then I feel like I'm sort of like in debt to them, you know? But I'm the type of person that will just, like, give the people I care about, like, my entire bank account if they wanted. I'd be iffy about it, but, like, I'd be like, are you sure you need it? Like, I kind of, can I not keep a bit? But if you really need it, sure. Have one more stitch left. Are y'all excited for me? I'm excited for me. It is right here. Just as I'm doing this, there becomes a knot. Goodness me. Please, I just need you to get through the hole. I don't care if there's a knot. Sorry if I'm being silent. I'm just trying to finish my cross stitch. I just want this to be done. I love it, and I've had a lot of fun, but also I feel bad moving on to a different project. Okay, so that knot is making it difficult, so we'll just tie a knot. Not how you're supposed to end a cross stitch, but I don't care at this point. I just want this to be over. I'm also sweaty, and I want to take my sweater off, but I don't have anything else underneath of it right now, so I need to switch into, like, a tank top. Hey. It's done! Look at how cute he is. Oh, I love him. You know what? Let's try. See if I can get this in this frame. I don't know how to frame cross stitch properly, so, like, it's fine. You know, being able to see anything, it's fine. Working on it. Let me try and, like, tape this. I have tape right? Yeah, let me tape this to the back of the cardboard. have to Google how to frame cross stitch because this isn't exactly working how I wanted it to, but tape is mostly just to keep it partially in place while I put the cardboard back in the frame, and then it's got prongs. Yes. I think that's good enough for now. I'll probably fix it later when I have more appropriate tools at my disposal, because I don't have anything for the corners or like anything. It's fine, hold on. We're just gonna take this tape off, and then you're just gonna pretend, you'll probably see it around the edge. You as chat are just gonna pretend that it's not there. You're gonna pretend you don't see anything because you're polite like that, chat, okay? Oh cute.
Look at that.
Need to like get it on there evenly and all that fun stuff, but don't worry about that. You don't see that. It's fine. This way. It's so cute. I love it. Very exciting. Finally done. I can just set it on my desk because it's got like a thing. Friend. I'm gonna be a teacher. Have this guy just on my desk, just hanging out, you know? Oh, I'm excited. He needs like a good press, and then I need to like stitch him in here, but I love it. Thank you for joining me. That's the stream. Hold on. Pull the headphone out. Where's my mouse? There's my mouse. Well, thank you for joining me on the adventures of making this guy. I've had a lot of fun. You guys weren't here for most of it. I did most of it at work. But this pattern is from the Witchy Stitcher. I love it. Great pattern. Recommend it. It's been lots of fun. I had lots of fun making him. Very excited to hang him around up on my wall next to that stuff. He's gonna go up there with all those things, and then I'll put him in, like, display him better for like Halloween and stuff. But oh, he's so cute. Oh, I love it. Thank you for joining me. This was fun. I hope you also had fun. Next stream will probably be the new year, probably on the 2nd. Don't know what I'll be doing then, but I hope you will have fun. Yeah, I think it'll be on the 2nd. Follow me on all of my social media. It's Saros_crafts everywhere. Just look it up, or there's link trees in most of my bios. Saros_crafts. I'm mostly on Instagram. I barely use Twitter. Twitter's going to shit. It's never been good. But if you follow me on Twitter, I might use it more. That's a lie. I probably won't. Just follow me on Instagram or YouTube. My next video is going to be out on February 14th. I'm working on it. I'm not going to pull it out. I bought the felt for it. So I hope you'll enjoy. Yeah, it's been fun.
I'll see you in the new year. Thanks for joining me in 2022. I was only gonna say 2020, and that's not the year it is. But thanks for joining. I've had fun. Hope y'all have had fun too. See you next year. Bye. I don't have two hands. I'm gonna wave with this hand and then close stream. Bye.